It was the night before Christmas when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung carefully by the chimney in the hope that St. Nicholas, or perhaps one of his rivals, would soon arrive. The children were reclined comfortably in their beds while aberrations of sugar plums and the like danced through their minds. All of a sudden, there was some activity out on the lawn, so I rose from the bed to take a look. I tore open the shutters and threw up the sash, which was connected to the antique-style window. It was surprisingly bright outside. The reflection of the moon on the snow gave the garden the appearance of mid-afternoon. And amongst the shadows, there was a miniature sleigh and 8 reindeer. Why were they there? What was their purpose? A diminutive and rather tired-looking old man appeared to be the sleigh's driver. I knew him to be St. Nick. Over the course of several months, I had tried in vain to arrange an interview with the man. Perhaps this could be a new opportunity. He called out to his reindeer, using nicknames for each of them. Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Donner, and Blixen, as I recall, although I cannot be totally certain. As he called their names, they rose up towards the top of the house, and as they passed by, I was able to observe a sleigh full of toys, puzzles, and games. The reindeer landed on the roof. Their hooves sliding around rather clumsily on the tiles did give some cause for alarm. It appeared that St. Nicholas was attempting to enter the house by way of the chimney. He was dressed entirely in expensive-looking fur, although he didn't seem to mind his suit being covered in ash and soot. A bag was flung on his back, filled with the toys, puzzles, and games that I had observed in the sleigh. His face seemed flushed, and his eyes were watering. Perhaps he was a little intoxicated. He was smoking, and he seemed quite overweight, but despite this condition, he was very happy to be there and was enjoying his work a great deal. In fact, his demeanor was somewhat contagious, and I found myself grinning from ear to ear. He didn't utter a single word but continued about his business, filling up the stockings with the toys, puzzles, and games. When his tasks were completed, he gave a nod and rose back up the chimney. He climbed onto his sleigh, whistled to his team, and flew off into the night. As he left, I heard him cry, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." No interview. Again. But maybe next year.